Hello everyone and welcome to another mining chamber video. In today's video we will be building this RX 580 rig. We'll be using 6 graphic cards with the Veddha frame. We won't be covering the build step by step since we already have a video that goes over that, which we will leave the links for in the description below. But instead we will be covering the finance part of this rig. So we'll be covering the electricity costs, the rig costs, and how much money you can make and when to expect to break even. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below, and we hope you guys enjoy the video. For this mining rig, we will be using the Veddha frame that we built in the competition between the crypto mining YouTubers. It was a fun community activity, so if you guys haven't watched it yet, we will leave the link of all three parts in the description below. And for the GPUs, we are using the RX 580's 8GB model. We have two different variations of these cards. We couldn't really find any information about why is there two variants, but one of them requires only one 8-pin, and then the other requires two 8-pins to power on. And then their heat sinks are also different. And as for the risers, we will be using the U-bit risers to connect the GPUs. For the motherboard, we will be using the ASUS B250 Mining Expert with an Intel Celeron G3900 and one stick of 4GB RAM. And since we will be mining on Windows 10, then for storage, we will use 120GB SSD. Our power supply is a Corsair HX1200. It has 3 PCIe strands with 2 8-pin each, which means we have a total of 6 8-pins that we can use. And since we will have to run 6 GPUs that will take more than 6 8-pins, that means we will be using as much splitters as we need to power on all the GPUs and as many risers as possible as well. And then finally, we are using a mini LCD screen just to monitor the rig physically, and it does add a great look to the mining rig. So we finally finished the build, but since we have only 3 PCIe strands with 2 8-pin each, we ended up using a splitter for each 8-pin we have, and we still cut short, and we were not able to power 4 risers with the 6-pin connectors. So instead, we used some SATA to 6-pin adapters for now until we can get some more PCIe strands. We do not recommend powering risers with SATA for any cards that use a high amount of watts. So if you're using Radeon 7s or any RTX series cards, please make sure to power the risers with a 6-pin connector without using any SATA or Molex adapters. Now that we've finished building the mining rig, we will go ahead and boot it up. We have everything pre-installed since the SSD in the mining rig was being used by the same rig before. All the drivers and overclocks are set, and we also have Claymore miner installed. But before we start mining, there are a couple of important things that we want to bring to attention. If you're using the RX 500 or 400 series cards, I recommend downloading the AMD Radeon 19.12.1 drivers, so you can flip your GPUs to compute mode, which helps your hash rate enormously. I was not able to find that option in the new Radeon drivers user interface, So I just stuck with the 19.12.1 version and I had no problems with it at all. And for our overclock settings, we used the configuration that we have on our website. We changed the core and memory frequency using MSI Afterburner, and then we undervolted the GPUs using the Radeon driver software. We saved the undervolt as a profile just so it is easier to apply on multiple GPUs by clicking load profile. Make sure to apply all the settings and the undervolts to all the GPUs, and if you have any questions, please let us know. And now let's take a look at our Claymore miner. Since we are using RX cards, we set in our script the parameter RX boost with the value of 21 and scrap with a value of 6. Both of these improve your mining efficiency and increase your hash rate. It all depends on what GPU you are using. We will go more in depth about the command line arguments for Claymore miner in a video very soon. So now we should be getting almost 30 mega hashes. We can push more on the overclocks, or we can mod the BIOS for the GPUs, and then like that we will be able to achieve more with using less amount of power, but we will cover that more also in another video. We are getting a total of 180 mega hashes and we are using around 910 watts mining Ethereum. Now let's calculate how much this rig costs to build, and then we will take these numbers to the profit calculator and see when will we break even. These prices won't be accurate, but they still will be close enough. Please make sure to look for used deals, and you can also visit nerdgears.com to find some good prices for hardware. So for our GPUs, we have 6 MSI RX 580s, which costed us about $110 per GPU, and the Ubit risers, which costed us $40 for 6 pieces. The Asus B250 Mining Expert motherboard costs around $70, but we were able to get it used for $40. The G3900 Celeron processor costs about $40 and less if found used. The SSD 120GB costs only $15. The RAM we are using is just one stick of 4GB RAM, which you can get anywhere for $20. And the Veddha frame costs about $40 when it used to be available, but we were lucky enough to receive one from Red Panda Mining, which we really appreciate. And for the sake of the video, we will just put the cost as $40 for now. The Corsair HX 1200 watts power supply costed us $180, and we purchased some additional splitters for $40, which ended up to be a total of $220. The RGB fans costs around $45, and then finally, the mini LCD screen can be found for $40 or less. So the total cost of this mining rig is $1,160. Now the next step is to put these values in a mining profits calculator. The one we will be using is from whattomine.com. So we will put the values we got, and our electric rate will be 5 cents per kilowatt hour. As we can see, this mining rig will make $3.59 per day at the current price of Ethereum being at $239. Our electricity cost will be $1.09, so after the electricity cost, we will make $2.49 in profit per day. Monthly, we will be able to make $74.80 in profits, which means our mining rig will take about 15 months to break even. You can feel free to visit the site and put in your own electric rate and see how long it will take you to break even. We will leave the link in the descriptions below. In conclusion, we think this mining rig is not bad for being your first mining rig, since it is more so on the cheaper end, and it is best to mine Ethereum and Ethereum Classic, since they are the most profitable on the RX 580 GPUs. Alright everyone, thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a thumbs up, and if you have any questions, let us know in the comment section below. So if you do need a step-by-step guide to build your mining rig, you can visit our previous video that we made about building a mining rig, or you can just let us know and then we can remake another one with more details. So thank you guys again, and we hope you have a wonderful day.